Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. All right, there we go. What's up, everybody? So, basically, you're just going to do separate ways to unlock the Chicago typewriter. For a video I have in mind. What's this? Oh wow, I actually misread that. I just saw a clip on YouTube and it was titled it's called Luckiest Kick of All Time in RE4 Remake. But I read it as Unluckiest Kick. And it was a clip on Verdugo and I thought, oh, what's gonna happen here? And if he just kills Verdugo with a kick, that's it. So yeah, it's pretty funny. Yo, what's up, Alan? How's it going, man? Yeah, I'm just gonna finish off Separate Ways here real quick. And get that done. Finally had my guitar lesson today. And it went really well. So, we shall carry on. Making very good progress on PN3. There's only one mission left to go on that. And I dare say I'll probably have that done by the end of the day, hopefully. Because the last mission is actually deceptively simple. Yo, what's up, Resident? I forgot to turn my bot on. So, we'll do that now. And yeah, then that's it. No more. No more obsessive projects to get to do. You know what was funny though? While doing this PN3 run, I got the idea to do something else and I thought, no, you know, you've gotta fucking stop. You gotta stop. Stop doing shit. You know? Yeah, it's not a full playthrough because I've already done the first two chapters, I think, because I started doing them offline.
Wow.
There we go. So, yeah, I think we're like two chapters in, I think. So, anyway. Let's crack on. Fucking blow up, man. I can't believe I missed two yellow herbs on that run. And, looking at that case, though, I think there is enough room to hold every single herb in the game and the Chicago typewriter. So, I might just do that run again for funsies with the Tommy gun. So... how am I feeling about it thus far? What's that? Sorry. What is that in reference to? Is anyone going to go and see The Flash? Okay, yeah, I've done the first two chapters. Yeah, I've never been the biggest fan of Separate Ways. Or Assignment Ada, for that matter. I really don't know. Because I felt... All the way through the game, I felt like I was doing pretty good and I hadn't missed them. But yeah, I got towards the end when I knew for sure how many were left and I was missing two and I thought, oh, that sucks. I guess it's fine. Like, I think trying to go through it quickly doesn't help. Hello? There we go. But yeah, other than that, it's been fairly successful. Mission 9, man, I tell you, Mission 9 in PN3, holy crap, man. Talk about a sleeper of a mission. That was insanely difficult to get. And I actually did skip a couple of fights in it, which I hate doing. However, the fights that I skipped, complete garbage, so... While I hate skipping fights normally, it is a fucking... It's a roulette spin whether or not you get hit. So I really don't care. And I'll talk about it more in, like, you know, because I'll do a full commentary run for that. But it's amazing how broken that game is on your first playthrough. The game does not work on your first run. It's kind of weird. What are you, boy? Especially on hard mode. I didn't play on hard, and funnily enough, my initial thought was to do the run I was going to do on hard mode. I am so glad I did not pick hard, because I did the first mission on hard, Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot I was playing RE4 Remake, where you just put enemies in a blind spot, you cheat. Is that a head-bitey one? Yeah. So, yeah. Separate is very disappointing to me. It's classic RE4. Yeah, basically, yeah. I feel exactly the same way. Like, you know, like, mechanically, yeah, it's fun, because it's RE4, but I feel like they could have done so much more with this. You know, they really could have. And I hope they do that in the remake. I really hope Separate Ways isn't just, you know, like a budget-ass tier B scenario thing. I hope they actually do something cool with it. And speaking of the remake, I'm still at the same point I was at on that run where I'm testing the rocket launchers. Because the other two times I've played it, a stray bullet has managed to kill Ashley both times in the water hall with the Chicago Typewriter, which is a perfect segue into the video I'm working on. I'm just working on a super quick comparison video between the Chicago Typewriter in the remake and the original, because I feel like in general, that's one thing the remake really fucked up. Was the unlockable weapons. I mean, the rocket launch is great and everything, but it's kind of... I mean, I'd be impressed if they managed to fuck up an infinite ammo rocket launcher. But yeah, the Chicago Typewriter and the hand cannon really suck in the remake. They're not, you know, they're really not worthy, like, infinite weapons, you know, if you know what I mean. Like, when the game has, you know, weapons that are actually better than you know, like, the supposed top-tier weapons that you unlock, it's like, you guys really did kind of fuck up. Ada's shotgun is also whack. So a Steam guide on it. You have limited RPG throughout the game, so we know it is not refilled once per chapter. Yeah, I mean, we already know that for sure. I'm up to the water hall, and I've bought two so far. And I know for a definite you can buy one. There's enough to buy one for Verdugo, Krauser, and Sadler. So you can buy... So you can buy at least four? No, five. Yeah, you can buy at least five. Which, you know, if you Google it, like, every single response is, you can only buy three, you can only buy three, you can only buy three, you can only buy three. And I think, okay. You clearly didn't test that. You know? Which is annoying, man. It's annoying. It is so annoying when people just... When, like, the over-purveying opinion is just that. It's an opinion. Like, it's based on nothing. And I think, man, people don't test shit anymore, do they? This playthrough, though, has made me kind of really like... I don't use the Blacktail that often, you know, because I'm not... I'm just not, you know... I don't know. I don't put my milk in before the cereal, do you know what I mean? I'm not one of those people. But the Blacktail is a lot of fun. It is funny. It is fun to just do shit like this. Okay, he didn't. He stopped running. That is fun. That is fun to do that. Separate ways could have seen Ada go through entirely different sections from the game. That could have been really cool. Yeah, it would. It would have been sick. But I think it's interesting now. What's up, Potato? It's interesting now to see the overall, like, the kind of the enthusiast opinion. Because when RE4 Remake came out, you know, when it first dropped, everyone was just... I mean, it's actually downright disgusting, like, how much people were, you know, praising it. And yet now, all the very same people are like, this game's fucking terrible. It's like, now that the game's had some time to breathe, you know, it's just... Which I think is interesting, because I've kind of gone the other way. In that, you know, when it came out, I definitely wasn't a huge fan. But now that I've actually played it more and understand more how it works, it's a very, very good game. But it's a very, very good game with just some really bad jank in it. Which is, I feel like that's most games at the end of the day. In the OG, the requirements to get the bonus weapons is harder than the remake. I don't know, man. All you got to do to buy the infinite rocket launch is just complete the game. Oh, yeah. She hasn't said that. Yeah, you only have to beat Pro. You have to beat Separate Ways and get... Yeah, the hand cannon is the one that's kind of... quote-unquote hard. But I think, but overall, the hand cannon is probably the, like, it's the least broken of the unlockable weapons. Like, you know, if you miss with the hand cannon, that can be your ass in this game. If you miss a shot, you can get killed. Whereas the Chicago typewriter is just, you know, insane. The PRL is for the, you know, like, serial last people that were somehow missing with the Chicago typewriter. You know. And I still think it would have been cool if they did, and they kind of did it in the remake, which was annoying. You know, the Chicago typewriter is an upgradable weapon in the remake, whereas in the original, you know, it's just default, you know, maxed from the very beginning. And it would have been cool if it was like the hand cannon, in that you could upgrade it, because then you can use it for other things. It's a lot of fun. Yeah. One thing the remake has made me do as well, like, I don't knife anywhere near as much in this game anymore. Like, it's just, you just don't need to. This game gives you so much ammo. It's kind of insane. Like, how much ammo you get in this game is actually a little bit insane. I'd say the jank of the remake is more apparent and more affecting than the jank in the original. Yeah, 100%. Yeah, and I think, I don't know if it's just, here's the thing though. Here's another thing too, to be a little bit critical. I don't know if it's jank or it's just the fact that at the absolute base level, they tried to make RE4 gameplay. They tried to cut and paste RE4 gameplay into the remake gameplay blueprint, which some people predicted from the very beginning wouldn't work. I don't know who that was. Oh, it was me. But yeah, you know, I think that's the biggest, like, that's where you get the jank. It's kind of, it is a side effect of that. It's just, you know, you can't do this game in the remake engine. It just doesn't work. Well, not engine. Blueprint, rather. I was just curious how many that would take, and man, that took quite a long. But yeah, like, that gameplay just does not work in that engine. It's just, they are built for different things, you know. You know, they're trying to do squats with a trap bar, do you know what I mean? It's like, yeah, you can do it, but it's not really what it's meant for. Wow, he just totally missed. Wait, that was funny. This game still looks good. It is. I am using the HD mod, so it is looking a little bit better. But I got mods to make the bonus weapons. Yeah, and it's funny that I bet if you look hard enough, I bet, like, there's people that, you know, are defending the remake based on that. It's like, well, you know, there's mods, and I think, yeah, okay. What if you're not playing on PC? You know, if you need a mod to fix a game, come on, man. But yeah, that said, I feel like the amount of stuff now that people are saying with the remake. Ironically enough, I don't know if anyone has watched. Oh shit! I don't know if anyone's watched Carsey's run, because Carsey did actually finish his No Damage run. And not to put too fine a point on it, but man, it's not his best work, shall we say? I think that's the easiest. That's the best way to put it. It's not his best work, because it really feels like he just. He was determined to play RE4 Remake like it was RE2 Remake and 3 Remake, and just, that's not how that game works. You know, you can't play a game like that. Motherfucker. And expect it to work. Do you know what I mean? You can't play Gears of War like it's Halo, and then complain that things aren't working. So, it's weird, really, because generally speaking, he's quite, you know, he's very in-depth on stuff like that. And his RE4 remake one definitely felt kind of phoned in. I need to see what he says about the remake. Yeah, I mean, you know, like, I think the long and short of it is that he really doesn't like it. Sounds like people. Yeah, it's exactly the same, and vice versa. You know, you. Well, I say vice versa, more like when people try and play NG like DMC. You know, the game doesn't work. Like, I can't launch this enemy and kill him for free in the air and have nothing even be close to touching me. It's like, that's because this game doesn't work like that. That's not this game. And and as I said, having played the remake a lot now, you know, I that's been kind of it's disappointing to see that kind of be the over common take on it now, is that, like, now it's just this garbage ass shitty game, and I think you're creating very much false equivalencies here. And I think watching some of I don't know how you say the name of the channel, but like the Ideal or ED channel, like a lot of his later stuff where he just went on like massive rants about the remake, I think, yeah, like, you're trying to play this game, you know, like it's something it's not, and like that seems to be the basis for why you think it's bad. And, you know, there's definitely jank in the remake. There's definitely stuff that doesn't work properly and doesn't work, you know, as well as we would like. But, you know, trying to play the game like a completely different style of game and then, you know, like tearing that it doesn't work and calling the game bad because of that, I think, no, that's on you. Sorry. That's just on you. Which version is better, PC or GameCube? I mean, you can mod the hell out of the PC version of this, so it's, I feel like that kind of gives it the edge. You know, this game on PC is pretty great. Hello, good sir. Fuck you. You want to turn around? Oh, you, two shots? Really? I suppose I did throw a grenade on him. I mean, the base version looks better. You know, the performance is a lot better. It loads faster. The GameCube. I mean, the GameCube version does have some like cool little quirks. But I'm trying to think, because it's been a while, honestly, since I've actually played the GameCube version. That's something I want to do pretty soon. It's a huge bug, but it doesn't give you the option to change your outfit. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that does suck. Yeah. I do like that the HD mod applies to this, though. I mean, look how good Ada looks. Look how good her dress looks in this version, man. Looks great. Looks wicked good. Has anyone seen the Mario movie yet? I'm going to go and see that on Tuesday. I'm going with a friend. I'm not really that fussed about it, but, you know. It'd be interesting to see it. I appreciate Eddie showing off some of the really bad jank in the remake, but he does go out of his way to shit on the game in every possible way. Not even... yeah, exactly, yeah. Yeah, there is, and that's my... Yeah, that's exactly what I mean when... You know, people... You know, they just have such a raging hate boner for something. And I think, come on, man. You know? Like, come on. Just... Tone it down. Just a little bit. But I mean, you know, that's... Well, can you shoot Leon here? Doesn't look like it. I never actually tried. But yeah, you know, that's just the currency of the internet, really. You know, there is no room for nuance online. And that's why you're seeing it now, you know, that now that people are, you know, like, digging into the remake more, like, this game is terrible! And some of the things you see people, like, do... And they get annoyed by. I think, no, that's just you having a shit strategy, my friend. I'm sorry. No, you know, no offense, but, you know, if someone tasks you with dismantling a brick wall... I totally forgot there was people through that door. Yeah, if someone gives you the task of breaking down a brick wall, right, how would you go about doing it? You would probably want some kind of hammer that's probably heavy, or some kind of maybe powered machinery. There is a guy behind me. I did not know that. What a bitch. Yeah. Could you break down the brick wall with your face? Yes, you probably could. Is that the best way to evaluate, you know, how to do said task? No. But that seems to be lost on people these days. The idea that, you know, the idea that you might just suck is, you know, doesn't enter people's minds anymore. My immediate first reaction to this is obviously the optimal and best way to do it, and if it doesn't work, that means the game is broken. Couldn't possibly be that just maybe there's a better way. I managed to have 50 rough rounds at the end of the challenge run the other day, and that's on pro. It's good. Do you mean on the remake? I mean, there's ways to cheese the remake. I mean, that's why, that's exactly what I wanted to do with that no damage run. One thing I've noticed Carsey mentioned on that run is that he mentioned about having the rhinoceros beetle early, like, breaks the game and breaks the economy and that, but I finished that game, like, I could have finished my no damage run with 700,000 in money left over. And I get the rhinoceros beetle way later than he does in his run. So I think, yeah, you know, it's almost like playing the game more gave me more information to be able to, you know, do better at the game. And I think he even says in that run, he only beat the game twice before he did that run. So he didn't really, like, beating the game twice, and especially if it's a game that you kind of determined to not like, I mean, you know, it stands to reason you're not really going to, you know as much. You know? What are the effects that are on him? Yeah, you get double your money for healing items, and he farms health as well in one of the parts. Like, he farms fish in that. I don't bother with that. So I think it's just one of them where, you know, sometimes, man, sometimes you can be your own worst enemy, and you can just be determined to not enjoy something. Wow, that chapter's really short.
Jack Krauser has been the subject of extensive study and research by the organization. His skills and personality have been tested both on and off the battlefield. If he weren't the best, he would become a liability that would jeopardize the rest of us. My conclusion? He's a great soldier. No more, no less. As long as he's well compensated, he shouldn't cause any problems for us. If he does start to get restless, I can take care of him. I've studied his combat style and can deal with that arm of his if necessary.
Do you think Ada, like, here's a question, right? Ada is basically saying, yeah, I'd body Krauser, like, 1v1 me. But could she beat Leon? Because Leon beats Krauser. Because Ada is, you know, super enhanced and all that, isn't she? So. Oh, the right. Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, the charm, Jason. I meant the charm. Yeah. I meant the charm, not the. Cause, yeah, the beetle is the item, isn't it? Stop Leon's assassination. All right, nice. Yo, what's up, Demon? Any thoughts on the Mortal Kombat 1 reveal? I mean, it was a cool trailer. That's pretty much what I was expecting. It's like every trailer now. You know, they put out a cool and you're like, that's a cool trailer. But I want to see some gameplay, man. I want to see that gameplay. I'm just curious what they'll do with it, because I really wasn't a fan of MK11. I really didn't enjoy MK11. So I really hope they do. I really hope they go, in a drastic different direction this time, and I mean drastic. I'd love to see Breakers go completely. I fucking hate Breakers. They won't though, because, you know, Breakers are, you know, super casual friendly. And I don't mean that as in, you know, I'm not hating on people that don't want to, you know, learn frame data. It's just MK, you know, MK's like main audience is just, you know, the casual. And that's not a bad thing. The people that get new MKs made are, you know, the Call of Duty equivalent of fighting game players. So, it's just, I just absolutely fucking despise Breakers. I hate them. I'm old school, man. If you make a mistake, I'm making you pay for that mistake. And the fact that, you know, you can just
got a selection
be like, nope. I hate that. Well, she got a drop on Leon and got owned by... I mean, that's true, to be fair. Yeah, she did, yeah. So. You know, throughout my playthroughs of the remake, I've not put any time into the charms. Weirdly feels like I'm cheating out the game by using them. I mean, yeah, it kind of does, but...
What are you know,
that's the game, you know? That is the
Thank
game.
You.
That's the game, man. They're in the game, so use them. You don't get points for not using them.
Thank you. Is that all?
That's kind of my, like, my way of looking at it, and really, like, you don't get points for not using them. So, you might as well use them. Is, you know, I can't remember, is the bow gun actually, like, good? Back How big is the bow time. Gun? This music is good, yeah.
What are you buying?
Oh, it's quite big. That's what she said. I want to see gameplay. Yeah, I mean, it's probably going to be decent. It's just, I was really kind of surprised that, I was surprised by how much I did not like MK11. I really, really did not like it. Not to sound Hollywood, but I did get invited to the promo event, you know, like, for that. Which was pretty cool, you know, it was nice to get invited. It's, you know, it's cool to get invited to shit like that. But... I remember playing it then, and we only had, you know, a little bit of time to play it. And I remember within the first, like, 30 seconds of playing it, I thought, ooh, I don't like this. Like, I do not like how this plays. This does not feel good to me. So I'm really hoping that... Whereas every other NRS game, to be fair, it's been the exact opposite. You know, I've immediately liked how they play. Okay, that bow gun really fucks up my case organization here. Which is, you know, annoying. Anyway, well, that'll do.
Thank you.
The bogan is big. Yeah, I couldn't remember the exact size of it, yeah. What's up, Daisy? A remake of the first MK? I don't think it's going to be a straight-up remake, but, And, you know, the NRS, they always do something very different with their games. The only exception is Injustice 2. So, I don't know. And the only thing that was the same... The only thing that remained the same across MKs was the meter system. In MK9 and MKX, you know, meter functions exactly the same way. You get meter for blocking, you gain meter for having attacks blocked, and you build it by taking damage and doing special moves. Like, that's the only thing that remained the same. Everything else was different, so. It's safe to assume that it's going to be different. It's just how different. And I am looking forward to Street Fighter as well. I'm getting Street Fighter day one. I don't think Tekken 8 is coming out in 2024. It's tricky to say that, man, because I'm kind of surprised that MK is out this year, to be honest. I am. I thought that was going to be next year, but yeah, September, man. MK's out relatively soon. It does mean that, yeah, you know, Evo next year, man. I'm going. I'm 100% going. I'm already kind of putting things in place for it now. There's no way I'm not going next year because it's going to be MK, Tekken, Street Fighter at the same Evo. It's going to be fucking... It's going to be so sick, man. So, if anyone is near that area, and, you know, we could have a ball. Was MKX the one with the broken moves? That doesn't really narrow it down when you're talking about NRS games, to be honest. MKX was the one with Run. That's the easiest way to, like, differentiate, I think. MKX is the one that has Run in it. Which was really fun at first, but... Not later on, unfortunately, so... I was hoping it'd be cool if she could use her grapple gun for that, yeah. Take that. Her shotgun looks cool, but... Anyone seen that RE4 remake tier list video? I did watch a bit of it the other day, and it's funny how, like, most people, like, most of the comments are just, you know, pointing out, you know, pretty funny things. The art style. I love the way MKX looked. MKX is my favorite of the recent ones, for sure. Like, I fucking loved that game. It just felt so... I don't think any MK has captured the MK1 through 3 feel of it just feeling, you know, just fucking raw. And, like, you know, that's the kind of game that you'd play as a kid and you think, I shouldn't be playing this. I'm not allowed. I shouldn't be allowed to play this game. You know, no other game has done that. Like, MK9 kind of came close, but MK9 had, like, a good amount, like, tongue-in-cheek. MKX just felt just fucking cool as fuck, man. I really do. I miss that game. And, you know, and a lot of it is just kind of my affinity for that time. I went back and Gabe has been making his way through the old podcasts because people have, I mean, not many people, but some people have mentioned that, like, you know, it'd be cool to have, like, a highlight show of HMK. But you know, that requires to going through and listening to all the old podcasts, which I don't want to do because I don't like hearing my own voice. But Gabe's been doing it. And I went back and looked at, like, a couple of little bits, and it's amazing how much happier I sound. Oh, shit. Amazing how much happier I sound in those videos, in those podcasts. Get fucked. So, I was that was a really good time for me. That was a really, really cool couple of years when I was playing MKX a lot. And my whole existence was just play MK, you know, travel, play MK, travel, play MK, travel. Like, that was pretty much all I was doing. It was cool. It's sad they nerfed quotes a few weapons in the remake, but it's fine. Do you mean... Oh. Didn't know that was there. Yeah, it'd be cool if they do, but... Who knows, man? Who knows what they're gonna do? Wait, can I jump over here? Can I pick that up, please? As to what to expect, I have no idea. Apparently Homelander's gonna be DLC, though. In MK1. Which is fucking awesome. So, I mean, that said, I mean, that's another thing that kind of bummed me out in MK11. MK11's got fucking Robocop, man. And I reinstalled the game to when he came out, because I thought, dude, Robocop, I have to play Robocop. I wish Robocop was in a more fun game. I wish he was. And it's like, you've got Robocop, Spawn, the Terminator. There's some amazing guest characters in 11. It's just, the game is just not that fun. So, that, you know, that kind of sucks. I remember always, I fucking hate this bit. I hate this section. I want to see you play that just for Homelander. Oh, I'm definitely playing Homelander. There's no way I'm not playing Homelander. No way. What's up, Maze? I may have hastily removed the remake from my account because it kept pissing me off. Oh, that's pretty funny. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. Oh, shit. Okay, where's the turret? I remember this bit all that well. It's new, but it's crap. Okay. Is there another turret there or something? Because that's not where those bullets were going. What is this, though? Like, I mean... Isn't their plan, you know, do the whole parasite? Oh, by the way, we have a fucking battleship. Where'd they get this from? Like, come on. Where's the continuity, man? This is Plan B. Just Plan B, invade America. Yeah, I'm sure that'll work. I'm sure that'll go well. Oh, shit. I forgot to reload my shotgun. What the? Oh, okay. Oh my. Okay, I see now. Yeah, there's gaps in that wall. Okay. Their plan B. Yeah, invade America with a single battleship. Yeah, sure. Unless it's full of Astartes, I don't think that's gonna work. I really don't think that's gonna work. I don't think that'll go too well for you. On that subject, has anyone seen the film? What's it called? Is it Olympus Has Fallen? I think it's the first one. Because they actually made a kind of shocking amount of sequels to it. It's basically about Korea. Basically, like, invade Washington and like take over the White House. It's pure nonsense, but it's entertaining. And you know, and they do it with, you know, like, seemingly way less than you would actually need. Omni-Man also got leaked to MK1. I could see Omni-Man working. And you know, like, there's gonna be videos already, probably, about, like, how they're gonna do Omni-Man and Homelander. They have the same power set, and you're like, well, Superman and Zod are an injustice. They managed, so that'd be cooler. But yeah, I really want to see gameplay of MK. It's really hard for me to get excited about games without seeing gameplay in them. I mean, it's cool that we're getting another MK, but let's be real, like, we knew we were going to get another MK. We just didn't know, like, what it's gonna be. Can you destroy these turrets, or do you have to? Man, it's been a while since I played this. Omni-Man doesn't have heat vision, though. Does he not? Does he not? I thought he did have heat vision. Oh, no, yeah, you're right. No, he doesn't, does he? No, he doesn't have heat vision. Well, there you go. They don't have the same powers, then. There you go. Problem solved. They're totally different characters. It'd never happen, but it'd be sick if Grundy was a DLC character, because I need Grundy back in a fighting game, though. Speaking of which, I watched Injustice lately. I watched that last week. The Injustice movie. I really liked it. Good. I thought it could have benefited being a little bit longer, though. It's very short. It's only like an hour and 20 minutes. But it was cool. Don't point. It's rude. Look at you, you stupid owl. Oh yeah, I remember. It's all coming back to me. It's all coming back. I kept experiencing glitches and just the game being the game in general. Yep. Oh well, I was watching. I'm still keeping a very watchful eye on the speedrun scene for RE4 Remake, mainly because I enjoy watching people suffer. And I was watching. What was it? I was watching Orch play, and he had a really good run going. A really good run. And he goes for a kick on someone, and the kick actually connects, but because of the way it connects, it like pushes someone next to him that wouldn't have normally been close. That enemy then shoves him, and he just gets killed instantly for that. Like, the shove just leads to him getting chained and just getting like stun locked like over and over again. And you think, oh man, it's like, and it's one of them where, you know, that is why in the original the melee moves have, you know, a certain amount of like residual iframes, so that you don't get completely fucked by doing something like that. And you would think that would be like relatively straightforward. Look how good her dress looks, man. On that note, I'm playing a lot of PN3, right? In PN3, when you do energy drives, there is a brief window of invulnerability after the energy drive, because if your super move just leads you to getting killed because of recovery, then it's, you know, it's not a great super move, is it? I found out that I can restore the game to my library. Okay. Yeah, see, the Black Tail's fun. But it ain't the Red Nine. We all know the Red Nine is the best. The Chainstone Mocking Man. Yeah, it does, but here's the thing. To play devil's advocate to it, right? Here's the thing. You are only ever going to get stunlocked if you are in very close proximity to several enemies in that game. So I put it to you, in a game that plays like RE4 Remake, why are you putting yourself next to multiple enemies? You know what I'm saying? If you play with matches, you are going to get burned. If you don't play with matches, you won't get burned. And now people might say, oh yeah, but I should be able to do that. I was like, why? That's something you hear a lot about with regards to the RE4 remake. You should be able to do this. Why? Where's that written? You know, it's like the no iframes. And granted, the no iframes, like, there's very valid arguments for, like, some things, but people wanting iframes on just everything that the original had, it's like, but why? You know? Just because the original had it doesn't mean the remake should. People act like, as I said, you know, people act like there's this, you know, there's this, like, rules 1 through 10 of making a video game. You think there are no rules. There is only chaos. Because the fire that I just set completely took away my ability to fire my weapon and even run. So now the enemies have free reign to just not give a fuck about the same fire. I mean, but why did you set fire? Why did you use fire in that situation? I'm only half joking, by the way, but still, it's something to think about. The stun is the biggest thing, you know? Like, the stun is garbage, don't get me wrong. But in a game where you know that stun is not guaranteed, you know, don't focus a strategy around stunning an enemy. You know, it's holy shit. Okay. Where do I go now? Okay. But you know, the whole Leon taking, you know, about half an hour, you know, to recover from stagger, from being, you know, even close to a fire, is really fucking annoying. And every now and then it will just get you fucked. What's up, 6-6? No, not really. I've not been fired for very long. Yeah, so I might play something else after this. I don't know. I might play some PM3. Is that just not killing them? Oh no, it is. Another turret. Alright. I just noticed the timer too. And like not remembering where to go. Do I go down here? Hang on. There is a map. Isn't this where I came in? Did I say something? No, not really. Just in that, you know, as I said, it's. Well, I did. What's it when you go? My point about the stun was that, you know, like, people complaining about the stun in the remake. Like, oh, the stuns and that, and the staggers. I think, yeah, that's true, but, you know, you know that's how the game works, so if your strategy revolves around a stun, then your strategy is bad. And, you know, there is a lot in the other way of, well, you know, it should work this way and it should work that way. I think, no, it shouldn't. Like, there's no rule book for gaming. There isn't. You know, like, for example, like, oh, you should have iframes after certain moves, like super moves. Like, okay, let's apply that rule to fighting games then. Doesn't work, does it? It's just... It's amazing the lengths people will go to just, you know, as I said, avoid admitting that maybe they're the problem. I just noticed my shotgun tank. I really hope this is the way, because, if not, I'm probably going to run out of time. And then you get the opposite, right? And then you get people say stuff like, oh, you know, remake apologists. And you're like, no, pointing out why you're just wrong, it's not being an apologist. That's not being a Capcom shill. Like, your strategy just sucks, mate. Sorry. That's, you know, sorry, but that's just real rap. Your strategy's just not very good. Again, the whole brick wall analogy. You know? I have people say perfect parrying isn't consistent. It is consistent. Yeah, that's something that, I myself also thought at first. But I thought, you know what? It's probably just me. I haven't put the time in to really learn it. And I haven't.
Welcome.
And yeah, everyone, you know, everyone God's now is, oh, like the parries are random. I think, eh, are they? Or just have you not labbed it enough? You probably haven't labbed it enough. Apologist, what does that mean? It basically, it's a way to... I mean, what it means is, like, you have people that will just excuse anything in a game. Or, you know, or something, you know. They'll just excuse anything and just say, oh, well, you know, that's part of the design or whatever, like, you know, or whatever. Like, you know, as a way to, like, refuse to criticize something or something actually being just, you know, a poor decision. And, you know, If you say anything in defense of a game that has issues, you know, people will just be like, oh, you're an apologist. Nah. You think, no. Like, you just suck. Sorry. But again, people don't want to, you know, admit that. See it a lot when seeing people play NG for the first time as well. Especially NG2, you know, like, oh, the way bosses work in NG2 is a really good... a really good example of that. When seeing people play that game for the first time, and it's understandable why they think this, but generally speaking, in most action games, when you fight a boss, you know, the boss will do an attack, and then you have a guaranteed like window where you can hit the boss and do damage. That is generally how bosses work in action games. However, it's not how bosses work in NG2 for the most part. NG2, you have to understand things like hit confirm. You have to hit confirm on bosses in that game. If you don't, you will get fucked. Parries are, well, counters are also really good on NG2 bosses. So, you know, think about your counters. Think how you can use counters. But the over, like, that's really cool, that is. But yeah, what people say is, oh, like, you know, this should be this and that. It's like, because it's like in a different game, you think, well, yeah, but it's not like that in this game. Deal with it. This is a different game. So, that's great. I mean, yeah, it is, but that's exactly my point. You know, it's a different genre, so it's not the same. You know, you have RE4. You know, there is a survival horror game. You can have an action game. You can have. It doesn't, like, you know, no two games are exactly the same. So expecting one game to play a certain way, or expecting certain things in one game because it's like that in another game, is... It's a different game, so just treat it as such. If your complaints just stem from, you know, this doesn't play how I think it should, then... Is that a bomb next to me? Stomping guy. Oh crap. Alright. NG2, I mean Ninja Gaiden 2. That's like the, you know, again, you know, just too based line incoming. That's what most people that, like, just refuse to learn NG2 complain about. Like, oh, like, the bosses don't work properly. And you think, yes, they do. You mean they don't work how you're used to bosses working? They don't work how they do in in other action games that you have played. Which again, you know, why should it? Why should two games play exactly the same way? God, I miss the rifle. I miss the rifle being so good in the remake. The perfect parry is consistent, but the system is not perfect. That's a good way to put it, yeah. I feel like you could actually apply that to some things in NG2 as well. Like, you know, something can be good, but the core system underneath it can be flawed. I'm not sure how his stuns work. I honestly don't know either on Krauser. I really don't. But I haven't really labbed it either, so. When Street Fighter 2 has like 8 variants and those play differently, you know you don't have to change much to change gameplay. Well, yeah, true. Good example. Which is why, as I said, which is why it kind of breaks down when you have kind of what I would call the more enthusiast scene kind of fall victim to it, you know? It's like, wait a minute, you know, you... people whose job it is to, you know, play video games, and you think, wait, like, you're coming out with the same, you know, sorry, like, you're coming out with the same kind of scrubby mentality as people that only play a game once. And yet, you know, like, you should know better. Yeah, NG2 is another character. Speaking of detection, I've had multiple instances where I shot an enemy 20 with a shotgun. Oh, yeah, happened to me too. There's a clip of that on my channel, actually. I put up a short of that. Excuse me. Okay, well, at least I can do that to you. Bitch. Alright. Oh, I shouldn't have sold that thing. Idea. Yeah, that's another thing about it. Yeah, so that's something in the remake that is just legit, like, a poor design. I say a poor design choice. It's not necessarily a design choice, because it's just how the systems work, but it's definitely a flaw in the remake in that, you know, grabs instantly damage you. The second, like, on the very first frame, a grab will deal damage to you. And you think, well, you know, if in real life, right, if I have a shotgun, just think about this for a second. If I have a shotgun, and in real life, someone goes to touch me, and they place a hand on my shoulder with the intent of doing me harm, but just as their hand touches my shoulder, I shoot them in the face with a shotgun. That's what is called, that's what you might call, an uneven trade. That trade is not in their favor. Whereas, no, in RE4 Remake, it's like, I touched you, therefore you just had a heart attack and your arm fell off. On the very first frame. They're like Dr. Manhattan, you know? So that's something about the remake that is legitimately flawed. But, play devil's advocate at the same time. You know that's how the game works, so... zone them out, man. Zone out enemies. I don't know if anyone's kept up with the Aether's channel, but his last update was that he's had several one-hit runs of RE4 single segment no damage. So I really hope he does bring that down. I'd be very interested to watch that. I'm just curious, like how he does it. You know, is he just gonna play insanely lame for the entire game? Because that's not usually how he plays. So is this the right way? Yes. Oh, what message? Sorry. Oh yeah, I have to like alt-tab out to scroll up chat when I'm playing RE4, which is really annoying. It's still not working. Alright, let me do it the old-fashioned way. Switch monitors. There we go. You could just... yeah, that would be much easier, yeah. Do that. Thank you. Yeah, that'd be easier. On pro, I don't even bother trying to parry an enemy unless I have any other option. I've started to parry more in the remake. I have. I have started to do it more. Because I think, you know, if you avoid doing it, then you're not going to get any better, are you? But it is tricky. Yeah, that's true. That's true, Maze. Yeah, you can, yeah. In RE4 Remake, the major melee options are limited. Like, they're a resource to help you get away. Just not having the infinite knife alone should cue you into stay back. I mean, yeah, but I feel like the knife is kind of a... I feel like the durability on the knife is... oh, yeah, I forgot to do the thing. Oh, fucking hell. You see, this is why I like emulators. Because you don't have to do... Yeah, there we go. I mean, you need to see RE4. What are you, some kind of heathen? You mean you haven't played RE4 enough to know exactly what's going on just by audio alone? What are you, some kind of scrub? God. God, man. Anyway, where am I going? I could do that. I reckon I could listen to RE4 audio and describe pretty accurately what's going on. But yeah, I think that's just, it's just the way it is. People just don't want to... People can never be wrong. These days. It's a shame. Their immediate thought is the right one. There's no room for reflection anymore. Man, there's a lot of shield dudes. Yeah, I was gonna say... Yeah, I feel like the durability on the knife, though, I feel like is a real placebo. I don't think that really changes the game all that much, because you get so many, like, with how many disposable knives you get, and how cheap it is to repair your knife, and how durable the knife is just after a few upgrades. I feel like if your knife is breaking a lot, like if you're constantly, you know, running into that problem, if your knife is breaking or something, I feel like you must be brute force just trying to play the game like it's OG RE4. That's, you know, because you have to do a lot to really wear down the knife. If you're a filthy parry backstabber like me, you need to repair. I mean, that's, isn't that kind of a good thing though? Because isn't that a good balance? Because that's a really powerful thing you're doing. You know, parry backstab is sick, but it is very, very strong. So, although, couldn't you just like parry and then equip a shitty knife for that, and then you'd still get like, can you get like 2 to 3 kills out of disposable knives, and then just save your main knife for stealth kills? See, you're not cheesing the game enough. You know. You're not cheesing the game enough, man. What are those words in the inventory screen? What words? Oh. My life has been saved. Oh yeah, I never noticed that before. Is that in the original, or is that HD mod? God, you get so much ammo in this game. Yeah, it must be an HD mod thing, right? Is this still chapter 4? Because this chapter's taking fucking forever. Oh, as I say that, I'm pretty sure this is the end of the chapter, right? This plus more will be revealed in the Mortal Kombat 1 story mode. Lots of origin stuff. If Melina was created by Shang Tsung in the previous timelines, then who created Melina in the same timeline? Oh, yeah.
Enough talk. Die, comrade.
Alright, I have a serious question for you guys. So, Melina, why can't I skip this cutscene? Oh, is that a quick time event? And I just mashed at the perfect time. Melina, would you? From MK? And I want honest answers only. So if anyone says no, you're full of shit. I resent the message from earlier. It's probably gone now, though, isn't it? Because I'm a scrub, and I missed it again. Yeah, I think I must have missed it again. If you repost it right now, I'll see it. Isn't the world record for separate ways, like, 20 minutes? I might... That'd be interesting to watch that. Game is designed to give me the ammo I don't want at any moment. Yeah, that's true. Oh, is it not just separate ways? All right. Let me resend it. Nice. Okay. Oh, shit. I almost shot him, just... I was like, oh, shit! Welcome. There is a dude here.
Gotta select. What are you buying?
I was gonna say, I really hope we get a bigger case. Come. Right. Oh, man. Probably gonna use a rifle more, actually. Aren't I? That'll work. Get to Chicago. Do you have to be both separate ways in Assignment Ada on the PC, but on like the newer versions to get the Chicago typewriter? I really hope not, because I fucking hate Assignment Ada. Behind it. Okay, never mind. Well, if you subscribe, you won't see any ads, man. I'm joking. I meant to post that on YouTube, actually. Anyone that's watching on YouTube. Do you get ads on YouTube streams? You know, when you're watching live? Because I've never really watched any streams on YouTube, so I wouldn't know. Why do they give you three slot items that messes up my case? God damn it. Alright. Ah, true, but the enemies just flinch to shots. I just wish the enemies just flinch to shots. I don't need them to give me a melee stun, I just want to feel satisfied with my shooting, and then when the enemies tank those shots to anything, I come away feeling less satisfied. Oh, 100%, yeah. And it's also stupid. It's also fucking stupid. It's just dumb that enemies can literally tank multiple. Keyword, multiple. Shotgun rounds and just not even flinch, and it's just that is fucking stupid, and there's no argument for that being good. I don't think I have, maybe when I first entered the stream on YouTube. Okay, yeah, because I gotta say, man, Twitch in terms of, like, streaming and that going forward, it's damn near pointless, man. I need to check on that, actually, but, I think it should be 3 minutes of ads per hour, because I have it set to the lowest thing it can be, so I think that's how many it should run. So, it's just one of them, really. But now, you know, subs aren't really worth what they were. Thank you. They got that. Yeah, they have, but sometimes they don't, and that is the thing that, you know, one thing that really bugs me about this game that genuinely pisses me off, and there's not many. You know, in this game, when you get grabbed clearly from behind, but you get a front grab, God, that pisses me off. Like, that hit me... Like, he grabbed me from behind. Like, that was not a front grab. It's so annoying. Yeah, it is. It's two ads for me every 10, 20... 10 minutes? What? Really? Okay, I need to look at that. It should not be that long. Yeah, it definitely shouldn't be that long. I am one of the few headless dude grabbing you too. That's true, but that happens way less often. Like, that's quite rare. Like, running past an enemy and having them grab you literally in the back and then getting a front grab, like... That happens quite a lot. This is sort of Ada's, like, lift segment. Not for daddy! Fuck. Yeah, there are, yeah, but it's just dumb. You know, if a grab hits you in the back, it should be a back grab. Shit. This is, I kind of forgot how combat heavy this is. This is nothing but shooting dudes in the face. Which I like. Am I supposed to be doing something here? Or is this just, you know, kill all the enemies that spawn? In the main game, having Ashley around always guarantees you always get a back grab if facing the other direction. Yeah, that's cool, but it should be like that anyway. Oh, fuck. Okay, that actually missed. Another shotgunning an enemy in attack animation. Yeah, sometimes they armor, yeah. So anything, any sort of inconsistency is just annoying in a game for me. I feel like, you know, if something works, it should work. It should just work. In the rear. No, I'm kind of like sloppy. Remake, yeah. But I mean, enemies deal damage like instantly on grabs in the remake. It's so bad. I was wondering, in the RE4 remake, there was the mode with the flaming chainsaw guy, or those guys in the full game. I never actually saw that in the demo because I didn't play it. Shit. But I'm guessing they're going to be in like DLC maybe, and maybe they'll add in a harder mode. Because there's already mods for RE4 Remake, for making it more difficult. Yeah, supposedly, like, they're the Super Salvadors that are going to be in Mercenaries. Am I Chainsaw Dr. Salvador? Yeah, he's not. Man, how many fucking crossbow guys? Oh my god. Where is he? Oh, Leon's already been through here. So. Shouldn't all of these guys be dead? Then, really? Oh shit, I should. Should have saved him. Oh, fun fact. You know that green herb there? If Mike destroys the tower with that green herb there, it despawns that green herb. Which is weird. Because I was going to pick that up on my run, and Mike destroyed the tower, and it wasn't there. And I thought, oh, you know, I'll pick that up later. And then he destroyed the tower, and it was gone. Motherfucker. So again, you know, Mike's just a useless piece of shit. He just destroys your health. I hate Mike. Fuck Mike. I'm glad he dies. One thing I wish you could do in this game is jump over the railings there. I love that you can do that. You? Got loads of bow down. No worries, Peter. Have a good day, man. I was gonna get an ice cream today. It's a super nice day for once. It's super nice today. It's sunny, it's bright, it's blue sky, it's not too warm. There's a nice breeze. It's a perfect day today. But I thought, no, I'm not going to get an ice cream. I've been slipping since I've been back. I have to admit. I have not been as strict eating-wise. And I was just thinking, like, you know, I gotta get on that. I gotta get back to doing what I'm doing. What's up, BT Mass? Hello. BT Mass. Is that short for something? Well, hang on a minute. You have some of that. What? Okay, well, that was interesting. cheating bitch. Yeah, that was strange, wasn't it? Take that. Yeah, but that's, like, that shouldn't have, like, that's not how flashbangs work in this game. Like, enemies can get flashbanged through, like, walls in this. Like, that should have stunned him. Anyway, never mind. He's dead now. I feel like they have way less health. Yeah, my rifle is, like, maxed. It's funny, the grenade just floating on her dress. I mean, to be fair, that's usually what the weather's like here, which is why days like this are so nice. And yeah, I really wanted ice cream. And it turns out, I saw on a bus ad, billboard, they do, is it Riello's? There's Ferrero Rocher and there's like Riello's or Riello's. They do ice creams of those now, and oh man, if you haven't tried those, they are so nice. Could easily just destroy a fucking bucket of this shit. Bitch. Yeah, I've always found that funny about the RE games, yeah. I'm trying to play the original RE4, and I've noticed that he breaks down the game. Oh, nice. Thank you. Yeah, got a few videos on this. There's a few videos. I broke 2,200 videos this week on YouTube. I noticed that. It's a whole lot of videos. I should probably use this bow gun, shouldn't I? Oh yeah, I just thought that scene's not in the remake, is it? Yeah. It's possible for flashbacks to completely ignore a flashbang if you throw one to the right as they transform. Yeah, that's true, but I also think, I'm wondering, is that because they're not technically spawned yet? Do you know what I mean? You know, they're not technically out yet. I wonder if that's why, how that works. What's my YouTube? My YouTube is the same as Twitch. Oh, you bitch. Yeah, that's a nice crossbow you have there. Mine's better. I do like that reload animation. I love a good reload animation. I just like, after all this time, you finally get a guy to cover you. I was sad when he died. I'm not. I cheer when Mike gets killed. I get downright aroused when he gets killed, because he's fucking useless. Hate Mike. Same with Lewis. People are like, oh, Lewis, he dies. I'm like, yeah, fuck this guy. Yeah, they do. Bows are... I guess bows are just cool, I think. There's something about a bow, I don't know. Bows are just cool. This guy. This dead body is sickening. Especially the mouth. I can't look at it any longer. Look, Ada. I forced you to look. All regenerators are beautiful. She just body-shamed that regenerator. I love that, like, Lara Croft get-up animation there. I don't have the TMP. Stop giving me TMP ammo. Oh, we have to... Oh, yeah, I forgot you have to fight Krauser. Okay, there's no... Wait, is it me, or is Krauser way less buff when you fight her at fighting Zeta? The Miri seems... Is that because he...
Come on.
Is that because he just lost to Leon? That's a great place to put me, thank you. Thank you for that. That's supposed to happen. Oh shit. At least the prompt to the dodge works, that's cool. Oh, not the dodge prompts I get for Krauser in this game. I blatantly pressed that, thank you. What?! I blatantly pressed that. That was annoying. The dodge prompt, oh, they're so bad in that, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. That might have been loud enough for you to hear. Like, I mashed the shit out of that. Okay, that was... I hate it when his arm, like, just tanks the hit. Actually, do you need to do that? Is one crossbow enough to do that? It might be, actually. Do they explode? Yeah, they do. Good job I saved all this crossbow ammo.
Come on.
How good is the... Seem to work. I'm invincible during my recovery. This isn't the remake, you scrub. Oops. I was mashing a bit too much then. That's actually kind of cheap. You can just like do that to... Wow, he's way less health than this. I'll send you the, link of the channel. Oh yeah, say yeah. If you just YouTube my name, it'll pop up because you know I'm Hollywood as fuck. It's annoying when you're trying to search for people on YouTube and just with the way it works, like it doesn't search names. I feel like you're quite lucky if that actually works for you. Is it worth going to the merchant? Has he got anything actually? I don't know.
Welcome.
Anything to buy him?
Got a selection. What are you buying?
I'll buy that. I've got a ton of health.
Come back anytime.
Right, time to fight Saddler. I don't remember the Saddler boss fight all that much. In separate ways. Is the bow good on him? Yes, that's the problem with quick time events in this game. Sometimes they have more active frames than the dodge will get you out of. Uh-oh. All right. I was hoping that would stun him. Does shooting that do more damage? See if these are any good. Whoa! Push down, fool. That seemed to take a while to get me out of that. I like how he has kind of got some, like, fighting game-esque moves. Okay, coming into this dead end was probably not the best idea. I pressed that, but I think I thought I was dead. Okay, the reload on that is kind of a problem. It's a bit too slow. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if shooting him does more damage, though. I'm just kind of assuming it does, but it might not. Oh, that's not... I thought that was his lung animation. Okay, does he just not move there? Okay, he seems to... Okay, I thought he would track you less than that, but he doesn't. Doing this, like, my, that is quicker than reloading. Okay, I swear I didn't take this many to get a stun this time. I swear I didn't take this many last time. Okay, is it me, or is he just taking, like, forever to, like, give me the, you know, hey, shoot me, stab my eye prompt? Jeez, yeah, it's not just me, right? This is taking, like, way more damage to get my, to expose his eye. Just figured, you know what, fuck it, let's just knife him. I didn't think that would actually kill him. Get fucked. Okay, that's how it works. Oh shit. You know what, now that I think about it, is the knife, like, good on Sadler? I feel like I've heard that. You can shoot Leon? Okay. I would like to get this over with, so we'll shoot Leon another time. Because I can't remember where I need to go here. I think this is it. Oh, it is good? Okay. Yeah, I feel like I've seen that mentioned in a speedrun somewhere. It's, like, not really indicative of how the fight with Krauser actually Sadler goes in Leon at all. There we go. Cool, I got an achievement. Okay, please tell me that's the Chicago typewriter. Please. I don't want to do a Simonator. Yay! Thank you. The soldiers, they have the infinite RPG. Oh yeah, that's true, they do, don't they? Yeah. Alright. Do they drop... Do they? Well, in the remake, they keep reloading. I think they do drop them in the original, actually, yeah. But yeah, but in the remake, they just keep reloading. Nice, we have the Tommy gun. Alright. Oh man, I can't remember what saves these are. Let's go with the longest playtime. That's pretty safe to assume I was lame in that one. The music is good in separate ways.
Got some rare. What are you
what
selling?
What do I have?
What are you buying?
100 grand. That's not going to be enough for the Chicago Sapphire. That's annoying. Surely I have a save. Or I've got enough money.
Got some rare. What are you buying?
That's not gonna be enough. What's this one? I've got so many versions of this installed on so many different things, like trying to remember what saves I have is impossible.
Got some rare things on. What are you buying?
Oh, here we are.
What are you selling? What are you buying?
No. Yeah. Nice. You see the clip Matt Drock had of one dynamite enemy lighting his dynamite with a delimbed arm? No, but that sounds pretty funny. Oh yeah. This is how this gun should be. How do I feel about Separate Ways in general? It's fine. I think you summed it up earlier. Like, it's fine. It's RE4, so it's fun. But, you know, it could have been so much more. Yeah. This gun's so good, man. Oh, I just noticed. Look at that. On the HD mod, like, there's actually the little notches on the magazine, on the drum mag, look. This mod is disgustingly good. Even fully upgraded in the remake, you know, it takes like a full-on barrage of bullets to fucking kill somebody. Yeah, it could have. I mean, let's be real here, man. The reason Separate Ways exists is because I think it was kind of a carrot on the stick for the PS2 version, you know? It's like, here's the PS2 version! It has brand new content! And you think, yeah, it does. Kind of. There's a question. You know, brand new content. If the two new areas with Ada weren't in it, would it really count as brand new content? Just putting an existing character, you know, in previous areas in the same game, like, does that count as new content? I don't know. Yeah. Yeah, but that's the whole point, Deity. Like, you know, unlockable. I don't want my unlockable weapon to be balanced. I want it to be broken as fuck. You know. I feel like that's the whole point of an unlockable weapon for something like this. It should be OP. In the remake, I think they really have fumbled the Chicago typewriter and the hand cannon. The hand cannon straight up just being just a like the worst magnum in the remake is fucking insane. Like it is actually the worst of the three magnums. Unless you've got infinite ammo. But again, you know, if that's what it takes, then, you know, kind of proves the point. And, I mean, unless you've got the cat ears on, like, I think the Matilda is actually the best machine gun in terms of raw firepower, but when you get the exclusive on the MP5, I feel like that is pretty good as well. But having to reload really does hurt them, yeah. So... I meant the typewriter. Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, you know, the it should be overpowered. In the remake, the Tommy gun is shit. If it wasn't for the fact that you don't have to reload it in the remake, it would be just legit bad. Because enemies just have way too much health. In the remake, its damage is only 2. It's 2 damage. In this, it's 10. Which, yeah, is nuts, but again, I don't want my end game unlockable weapon to be fair. Yeah, they nerfed the fuck out of that. And also, look at this. Look how accurate this thing is. This thing is a fucking laser beam. This is how it works in the remake. That's a very accurate representation of the bullet spread in the remake. Do you see that? Can someone clip that? It's like, hey, I'm alive. The game's all you cheating fuck, you die. They just fell over. Loki is one of the most satisfying things with this, is to just like one tap them in the head. But yeah, in the remake, the accuracy is just, oh god, it's painful. Salvador disagrees. Yeah, in the remake, this is like, there's your spread. Leon is just straight up Call of Duty aimbot. in the original with this gun. We could play some more of the remake, actually. Because I still have that run to carry on. You got the cat ears. Yeah, yeah. Say that it's such a nerfed weapon in the remake. Chapters 4 and 5 are the only ones with any new content. And part of that is from the areas before. Yeah, that's true, yeah. I haven't used the Striker much in the remake at all. I feel like the riot gun's just too good. The riot gun is just insanely good, so it's definitely one of those, why would I even bother using, you know, any other shotgun? I just need to get to the bosses to work on that video. I mean, it's probably still a pretty legit weapon. It's just with how, I think what makes the Matilda so good in this game, by comparison, is that this game is very, very generous with ammo. So even though the Matilda is a bit of an ammo drain, this game just gives you so many bullets, it's not as big of a deal. In the remake, you're not constantly sitting on like 200 pistol rounds. So. Yeah, and in this, you can't quick turn with the Matilda. Although, apparently, there's a fix in the tweaks for this where you can actually do that. Which is pretty cool. Which magazine is better in the remake? Broken Butterfly or Killer 7? In this game or the remake? In the remake, I'd say Killer 7 because the spread... It takes so long in the remake for the Broken Butterfly to, you know, to actually focus and get an accurate shot. It's way too big of a handicap, I think. The accuracy is definitely what you want. In the original, Broken Butterfly, but you have to put a lot of money into it. Now. That's the thing. You have to put a lot of money to get that upgrade on the Broken Butterfly, whereas a default Killer 7 is almost as good as a maxed Broken Butterfly without the exclusive upgrade. So it depends. It depends on how you look at it. The Killer 7's only 70,000 or 77,000, whereas in you know, that's not a lot of money. Whereas the Broken Butterfly takes a ton of money to upgrade. You get it earlier. You get it in 3-1, but Magnum ammo is extremely rare. So, you know. Yeah, it does show up really early. And in the remake, it's a lot cheaper too. Like, it's super cheap in the remake. And you can craft Magnum ammo too. So if you want Magnum ammo, you know, you can get more.
What are you buying? What are you selling? Is that all?
Just occurred to me what I was going to do on this run. I was going to try and collect all the herbs, but I've left some behind, haven't I? Oh. Matters not. I mean, you can just, you can post the link in chat. I don't have links, auto-set. Anyone watch Bork very often? Bork on Resident Evil? I was watching him the other week. And he had, you know the shield guys in the remake? He has, they've got, it's like blue, and it's got IKEA written on the front. I just think that's really fun. That downward pitchfork stab, man. crazy. You'll craft magnum ammo though? No, you wouldn't, no, because you only get two fucking bullets, right, or something. What am I doing up here? I'm going completely the wrong way. He got, I saw it on YouTube, I watched it on YouTube rather than the run. He recently got a new record in RE3 original speedrun. Not world record, I mean just a new PB. Man, speedrunning that game, why the fuck would you do that to yourself? This is a perfect time to test something. I can't remember if dynamite guys blow up after a certain amount of time in this game. That guy ain't going anywhere, so... Yeah, RE4 Remake has brought quite a few people to the Discord, which is cool. The Discord has been quite lively. Yeah, I don't think they do either, but I feel like that's been debated. And yeah, I'm pretty sure they don't, like, unless they do something with it, it won't blow up. Hello. Yeah, you might be right on that maze, actually. That sounds right. For anyone that missed it the last time I mentioned it, I was just thinking about movies. I watched Fall a couple of weeks ago, and I mentioned that the phrase "tickle your whistle" is in that film. And I thought, motherfuckers, you stole that from me. You stole that from my stream. Because that's not a saying. You know, the phrase is "tickle your fancy." That's the phrase. That's the saying. And also, there is a very, very prevalent, you know, on, like, sort of social media plot thread in that film. So it's not crazy to think that the people involved have been in a stream or two. I'm only half joking, by the way. I don't actually think they stole that. I just thought it was a funny coincidence. Motherfucker. At least they don't damage you in the remake, which doesn't really make any sense, but it is nice that they don't actually deal damage. I think this costume looks a lot better in the remake. They always look kind of shit, right? I've never found this costume. Bear traps don't deal damage, but back grabs do. Yeah. No! You will not escape. That crow was in league with the enemy. I'm telling you, man. He was up to no good. Who was I saying was in stream? No, I was saying if you've seen the movie Fall, I was asking if anyone saw that film. Wait. Did I forget to do something? Why is there no enemies here? Oh, I didn't get the key. Didn't get the key. Yeah, I was like, what the hell? But yeah, the phrase "tickle your whistle" is in that film. And I just thought, oh, that's funny. Like, that's a funny coincidence. It's good. I enjoyed that film. It's very good. It's very good. It gets a lot out of that premise. It really does. Oh, as in where the big cheese shows up? Oh, okay, yeah, I can do that. Not watched this cutscene in ages.
Oh,
I love how Leon is supposedly, you know, a trained agent, and yet the first thing he does when opens a door is not check his flank. I'm not trying to tell you how to secret agent or anything, Leon, but, you know, just... Come on, bruh. You never played Splinter Cell, man? No bullet hole. That, and he decides to kick Mendez upon first meeting. Yeah. That's one thing I do like in the remake, how, aside from the first encounter, his initial instinct is to just murder everybody. You know? When Salazar is all like, you are a... You know, when Salazar's just running his mouth and he just shoots him in the face. I think, yep, that's what you would do. And when Sadler turns up, he just shoots him in the face. It's like, no, like, don't fuck around with, like, these guys aren't... You know, these guys aren't in it for talking. Mendez confirmed to be the best stealth character. Yeah, despite weighing like 500 pounds, probably. What are you all doing here? This is my village. See, this is what I want my weapon to be. To be fair, if the Chicago typewriter in the remake was at least accurate, it wouldn't be that big of a problem. It really wouldn't matter all that much. Alright, I'm just gonna put him in a quick save here, because I'm doing this to get some footage, so I need some saves. Should play the remake? Or should play a good game? See what I did there. We could play the remake, or we could play something good. I'm surprised the HD mod guys didn't put the dead body for the Lewis cutscene and the bullet holes there. Always wondered why they weren't something you saw outside of cutscenes. Yeah, I mean, you know. They are only human, I guess. They can only do what they can do. I really don't feel like playing the remake, though. You know what comes out on Tuesday? Bolt Gun. Oh, I'm looking forward to playing that. I really am. I think it's been playing RE more lately and being on and watching a lot more Resident Evil streams. There's a surprisingly high amount of female RE streamers. I never really knew that before this, but I've been watching a lot of RE4 streams lately, so I've been getting Resident Evil streams recommended to me a lot lately. And yeah, there's a lot of ladies into Resident Evil, which is cool. Am I going to play Bolt Gun on stream? Hell yes. What do you think I am, some filthy Xeno scum who wouldn't play Bolt Gun on stream? That sounds like heresy to me. Women do exist? I don't know. I refuse to believe it. There is no video evidence of that. I have not seen concrete proof that women exist. Further to the point, I have not seen concrete proof that females that play Resident Evil exist. So, I reject that hypothesis. That sounds like heresy to me. Yeah, I actually am going to play PN3. I feel like just having a bit of fun with it. Alright. The Earth is flat too. Yeah, exactly. The Earth is flat and women don't play Resident Evil. These are two universal truths that we all know. Alright. No worries, BT. Thanks for stopping by, man. I'll catch you later. I'm just going to briefly update the stream. There we go. No, wrong one. I've only got one mission left on PN3, man. I've only got one mission left, and then that's it. No more projects for me. No more. No more. I can't remember if the Papillon suit in PN3 has two L's in it? I don't think it does. We'll soon find out. We shall soon see. I love that PN3 is actually in the Twitch database. There we go. It wouldn't surprise me if it wasn't. Maybe more projects next year. No way, man. Do you have any idea how long it's going to take me to get through the backlog I have? It's not even funny how long it's going to take. Because, you know, I don't just want to play the games that I have to play, like, once. Do you know what I mean? I want to do what I did kind of with RE4 Remake in that, you know, I want to keep playing the game and playing the game and playing it until I get bored of it. And I have a lot of games to play, so. Right. I just thought I don't need to. But yeah, so that's my run. I'm at the last mission. You know what? Just for shits and giggles, this will kind of ruin the video, but let's just have one run. And if I get it first try, I'm just that good. Right. Make sure turbo is on. Because we need turbo. Yeah, I guess you could say my backlog alone is a project in and of itself, you know? You could say that. I really like the music in this mission. It's very somber. It's good. But it's still got, you know, like a good, like, underlying beat. You know, as well, because I really wanted to make, you know, like a... I really wanted to do, like, a good thumbnail for this run. And it's amazing, for a character like Vanessa, I feel like if the game was more popular, it wouldn't be that big of a problem, but... It's amazing how little, like, artwork and, like, custom, like, images and that there is of her. You know? In any other game, I feel like there'd be way more. But yeah, not so much. Yeah, I love this game's soundtrack is awesome. There's a lot of points in these two rooms. So getting full combos here would be very nice. I hate the lock-on priority in these rooms, though. Like, why is it locking on to the one further away? No! My combo! Piece of shit. I did mess with... Okay, so here's something. I'll showcase this at the end of the mission or wherever. But just know how fast I'm firing, right? So this is with a turbo controller on. And this is without any upgrades on the speed, right? I mean, there's plenty of fan art of her in a Stars outfit. Where were you looking? I was just looking on, like, wallpaper flare. Steam grid. Are you looking on dodgy websites? Is that what I'm hearing? Are you looking on some dodgy shit? That said, I feel like I managed to do a pretty good thumb. Photo mode is a really nice feature in games. It is, yeah, I really like photo mode. That's one of those things that seems kind of... Oh, shit. Okay, well, there we go. We're not going to get the run. We'll play it out, though. Oh okay. I wondered if that's what you were doing. But, you know, I thought maybe you're on some dodgy shit. Maybe you're on, like, you know, VanessaXXX.com. You know? If so, I mean, come on, like, you know, be a gentleman and share the link in chat. Don't be a scumbag. This game looks so good on emulator, though. It looks so crispy. Yeah, so a speed run was the idea I had for this game. I was initially thinking, like, once this run is out of the way, like, oh, you could start speedrunning this game. No, no, no. Stop. You have a sickness. Fun fact, what I thought was going to be the hardest part of this mission is the last boss, but I was labbing the last boss this morning, and I thought, turns out, the last boss is actually going to be quite straightforward. That's what Claire's for. Oh, did you watch, speaking of RE2, did you watch that video in Discord, Justin, about RE2 Remake? I felt like she made a lot of good points about Claire, but I did not notice on my first run. Well, I say on my first run. I just didn't really pick them up. But I guess that's because I'm a dude. I got hit in the rear. I wasn't sure if you could get hit from the other one, but that's good to know. Yeah, it's a good watch. Same. There's like there's definitely some nitpicky stuff overall. But I think, you know, generally, I feel like she definitely does make some very, very good points about that remake. It's more narrative focused because my gripes with it were more gameplay orientated, but. Yeah, there's some very good points in there about the characters and that. Yeah. Shit. Oh, well. That's fine. I'll let you know when I have. Cool. Yeah, it's good. It's the only video on the channel. Because it feels like that video would have taken a lot of work. Maybe she was one of those people who, you know, started a YouTube channel and were thinking, I'm gonna put a lot of work into this video and, you know, make some really good points about things that people haven't really talked about, and it's gonna spark some really good discussion. And then the comments, like, she probably got a load of comments on the video that just said, nah, you're a woman, so you're wrong, nah. And then she probably thought, oh wow, so this is what YouTube's like, okay, fuck this. Unsurprising. Don't ever have high hopes for the internet. The internet is a cesspool. Everyone knows this. There is nothing good on the internet. Except my channel. My channel's the shit. My channel is the best thing on the internet. We all know this to be true. Everything else is garbage. Yeah, it does, yeah. But I say, there's some good stuff in there that, as I said, I never really thought of. One of my gripes with this game, after coming back to it, and doing this run on a new game file, the item drops in those little canisters are random, which is fucking stupid. Some of them are fixed, like there are some ones that are fixed in the game, but they tend to appear at the very end of the mission. I don't have to do this one. I just want to get to the boss, really. Practice the boss a bit. Yeah. Oh no, you do have to do this one. Got that. I posted a video where I allowed a cheese Krauser, and people be saying it's easy to eat Krauser when you have 13 magnum rounds, and they missed the point. People missing the point. Yeah, they do that. They do that a lot. Here's what you got to remember. The average internet user is a moron. Unfortunately. That's just what you do. One thing I really do love about this game, and it's easy to not notice it, but it's just the amount of detail in the enemies in this game. It's really pretty impressive. Like, let me just make sure I don't get killed. So, of course you do that, bitch. Okay, I can't believe he's not. Yeah, like, it happened. Yeah, so, like, look at these dudes, right? Look at, like, the little wheels on the bottom of the, on the bottom of their feet, and the way they kind of, like, they their weapons build out and then fold back into themselves. Like, there's a lot of detail in these enemies, and it kind of, and because you're not, you laser focus so much on just what attacks they're doing, you know, you don't notice, but like, if you actually just like stop and look at them, like, there's so much detail. It's really cool. Ads don't. Okay, you people get. Okay, I need to double check the ad settings because you should not be getting that many. Although, I don't know, maybe they've changed them. I don't know. I must admit, I don't really keep a very close eye on what Twitch do because I just kind of don't care anymore. Sorry. Would I be curious to see Susie Hunter's analysis of RE4 Remake? It's more a narrative analysis, so I don't know if that interests you a whole lot. I thought it was really good, despite some disagreements I have. I don't know who that is, but yeah, I could probably watch that at some point. But yeah, I've never been, you know, never been a huge lore guy, so, you know, the narrative stuff I don't tend to seek out. This is probably the worst room in this whole level, because these guys are total fucking garbage as an enemy. Okay, where's your... Okay, your friend isn't... I love it when that energy drive just saves you, like, at the last minute. That's so cool. Yeah, feel free to post it. I love how he's actually stuck on his body. I love the animation on that backwards jump. It just looks so good. Twitch likes money. I mean, yeah, it's true. It's just, I don't know. There's not really any point to me, like, stopping streaming on Twitch. It's just, as time goes on, like, the experience just gets... I mean, even some of the streams that I've watched lately... like, the amount of ads some people are running, it's, like some people literally have, like, 15 minutes worth of ads per hour of streaming, and I think, and then they complain that they're losing viewers, and I think, well, dude, what do you expect? Not everyone is gonna subscribe. But I feel like, you know, that's their motivation for it, is I'll do more ads, that way people will subscribe. Okay, can he not hit me? Wait. Oh, I do miss. Okay, yeah, so keep this in mind, right? Oh, shit. Fuck now. I was totally not paying attention. Keep this in mind. Keep, you know, the amount of, keep the amount of damage I'm dealing in mind on this palm shot. Because I never used to think that there was that big of a difference between, you know, a turbo controller and just full auto fire in this game. Oh my god, was I wrong. Two viewer streams running tons of ads. Yeah, that's something I've noticed as well. Like, newer streams having loads of ads. And I think, dude, you can't even get subscribers yet, and you're running a ton of ads. You know, it's so weird that how that's changed in the. Now there's this expectation of making money from the get-go with doing streams. What's been funny, by the way? Now there's that expectation of, you know, I'm making content online, so I'm entitled to some kind of money for doing it. Nope. Unfortunately. That's not how it works. We'll see if we get it. Yeah, it would have. While looking, you know what's funny? While looking for like artwork for this game, I did see a box art mock-up of a PS3 version of PN3. And I thought, oh man, I wish it had come to something else. I use auto fire for Krauser's quick time event. Oh yeah, exactly. Yeah, you should. Can you even turn off ads on Twitch anymore? I don't think so. Because as I said, mine should be set to the minimum. But I think they're just there. But, and I mean, as I said, you know, like, Twitch revenue is a joke at this point. So this game for super cheap, but never picked it up. It is, actually. Funny you mention that. It is. This game is very expensive now. Well, I say very expensive. It's all relative. This game will set you back anywhere from like 40 to 50 pounds now on eBay for a physical copy. Well, I mean, as opposed to that, there are only physical copies of this game. But having said that, playing this game with the GameCube controller. Oh man, don't do that to yourself. The GameCube, the GameCube controller is crap anyway. The D-pad on the GameCube controller is so bad. And the D-pad is so important in this game. Like, being able to get consistent inputs on the D-pad is so important. The D-pad on the GameCube was made for, I don't even know, microscopic humans. Yeah, so did I, and I was even tempted for a little bit when I kept seeing this game mad cheap. I was so tempted to just, you know, buy like an extra copy. That was stupid. For no real reason. I wanted to give it a hug. Yep. Alright, time for the boss. Is there a good emulator for Mac? I don't know. I don't use Mac, so I don't know. Does Dolphin not run well on a Mac? This runs really well on. I don't think Dolphin is super resource heavy either. I think it's fairly straightforward. All right, I'm gonna test this now because I don't really need to keep this in. Eternal Darkness as well. That's on the replay list. Have the newest mode. Yeah, I mean, yeah, hardware-wise, there'll be no problems. Like, it won't be a hardware. I think he's about near where he's gonna trigger the next phase, but that is a one-hit kill, if that hits you. So you can actually destroy, like, all his turrets. It makes this fight a lot easier. I wanna get to the final boss. Quick. I'm not doing that. Man. I'm not quite sure where you were aiming that. No energy for the next phase. Not the best. Okay, this is where I might regret not taking out his other ship. This boss reminds me of Griffin in a lot of ways from DMC. We're actually getting very lucky here. Say, because he hasn't done that attack yet. That attack is some garbage. Okay, we're getting some stuff to see. Okay, last boss time. Now, depending on what pattern he gives you, you can actually just destroy this guy very, very quickly. But I always find it's best to... It's always best to assume that you're going to get a shitty pattern instead of a good pattern. Basically, you just want to save your energy drives until, you know, as late into the fight as you can. Because they deal tons of damage. Oh, I remember that. I'm a palm shot damage upgrade down here compared to my run from earlier. So far, this is good. You bitch. Okay, this is not, like, the worst pattern. Shit, it's not the worst pattern, but it's definitely not the best. Stop spawning your fucking little bitches. Okay, this probably is like the worst battle. I wish you could shoot from crouched. Okay, not the worst pattern, but definitely not far off. Okay, I'm not sure why, but with, so you'll see something here. With the way this energy drive works, Harrier, if you angle yourself to the left like this, you'll see two projectiles go towards him. Look how much damage that does. If you do it head on, you only get one hit. For some reason. I don't know why. Yeah, you see how that one, like, pinged off and went in the wrong direction? That attack is, like... Okay, I was gonna say deceptively simple to avoid, but then just as I realized, I dashed and not ran. You wanna run for that. Did I ever see another Mayo's video? No, I didn't. I don't really watch a whole lot of Mayo's stuff, to be honest. And especially regarding stuff like that, because it's just not based on... It's arguing just, you know... It's arguing against stuff that is just, you know... Whether RE4 saved or, like, Resident Evil is not debatable. If RE4 had bombed... Like, we would not have gotten any more games ever. Probably. You know, it's just... Yeah, it is. It's because I've angled it, yeah. I've also some interesting points about how differently the series might have gone had they released the RE1 remake on PS2. They couldn't have done that, though, because there's no way the PS2 could have run RE4 remake. If they did RE1 remake on PS2, it would not have been the same game. It just wouldn't have. And it's and that's the thing about, you know, it's all well and good, like, arguing hypotheses and that, but, like, that's not an argument. You know, saying, oh, well, this may have happened if this didn't happen and this happened and this happened, like, this could have... It's like, yeah, okay, true, but that's not an argument. That's just saying, well, this may have happened if this didn't happen and this could have happened if this didn't happen. Yeah. That's true, but... That's not how things work. Okay, so this is a good pattern. What if Code Veronica and RE0 had set, like, you know, record-breaking sales numbers? Like, we may never have gotten RE4. They would have carried on just making, you know, tank control style Resident Evil games. And again, that's another pitfall of the modern kind of video essay or video topic is, you know, people putting across stuff like that as, you know, like merit for why what actually happened wasn't true. You think, well, no, like, you're not making a point. Oh, it makes me sad. It makes me sad how far like critique has fallen. Fun fact, you can actually jump off the edge here if you're not careful. Cheeky. Capcom threatened Mikami that they'd stop making RE games if 4 didn't succeed. There's your answer right there. And that's kind of a problem with a lot of Mayo's content. Like, it's not researched, it's just opinion focused. He's one of the worst, like, he's not terrible, but, like, when he's bad at doing that, he's maybe the worst in that, you know, very much, this is my opinion, but I'm putting it forward as if it's, you know, concrete evidence, and you think, no, you know, it's really not. Then the video would be how RE5 saved the Resident Evil series. I mean, RE5 did super well, you know. He brought up how most of RE's fan base was on the PS1 and would have been in the PS2, but the switch to GameCube affected maybe those players' ability to play the game, considering they had invested in the PS2 over the GameCube. For the general reasons why that console was more popular. I mean, yeah, I mean, that's relatively safe to assume, but how does, but like, how does that, okay, so in a way, that con, like, wouldn't that then contradict that Resident Evil 4 saved the series? If Resident Evil 4 was on the console that nobody owned, because all the Resident Evil fans had a PlayStation, why was Resident Evil 4 the ridiculous success that it was? People bought GameCubes to play Resident Evil 4. You see what I'm saying here? Resident Evil 4 was then ported to the PS2, which even the most insane, you know, anti-Nintendo fanboys would still say, yeah, the GameCube version is better, but the game still sold like crazy on the PS2. You know? That game sold really well on PS2. Yeah, this is a very short game. Yeah, I think RE7 is now the best-selling one, yeah. Most of RE4's profits came from the PS2 port, if I recall, though. Okay, I'm very skeptical on that. Like, is that actually, like, is that... Are there, like, actual sales to back that up? Because... I mean, that wouldn't surprise me if it was true, just because of how many PS2s there are out there by comparison, but still. And also, RE4... that's done really well in re-releases since as well. Again, it's one of those, man, like, you can not like RE4, that's fine, and you can prefer the old styles, but to make the case that Resident Evil 4 wasn't the Resident Evil that saved that series is just... like, come on, man. Like, just come on. It's just... what are you smoking? RE7 is good. It makes me laugh how she's got, like, magazine pockets on her little utility belt. Although, fun fact, there is some pre-release footage of this out there. And I think originally she was supposed to have guns in the game. Like, there were supposed to be guns that you could pick up and use. So. Bit of trivia. Alright, let's actually... yeah, so keep that in mind. Keep that in your brain. Of how fast you fire with turbo control, with a full turbo controller on. Which one is it? I think it's this one. RE2 Remix surpassed RE5 in sales too. Oh, there you go then. Yep, here we go. I was going to put it on easy, just for fun, but we'll keep it on normal. We'll keep the difficulty the same. I hope this save has money. Or at least I hope this is, you know, fully upgraded. You know what? I think it's the other save. Yeah, I think it's the other save. Well, it doesn't matter. I can still... yeah, I thought this... yeah, let me just load the other save real quick. I think it's the other one that has the suit actually upgraded. Let me have a look. Oh, no. Look. Ultra Guardian... that looks like it. Oh, no. Never mind. You know what? It doesn't matter. This suit will serve the purpose. So. I thought... hang on. I've got to try my other save. I swear I've got a save with Papillon in play. Should I get Dead Space 2? Yes, you should absolutely get Dead Space 2. Dead Space 2 is sick. Alright, let me check this out. Oh man, did I? Shit. I really thought I had a save with Papillon in play. Alright, well, never mind. We'll soon be able to upgrade it. Yeah, so this is full auto. By comparison. And I wish the game, you know, had this by default. I really do. I think this should have been, like, your default shooting speed. Because on the base damage palm shot, it wouldn't really be that big of a deal. Look at that. Just look at that. Like, how much faster you fire. Like, it's fucking crazy, like, how much faster that is. And I really wish that was the default speed. I just want to try something here, actually. Yeah, so fun fact, look, that's me turning turbo on. It's actually slower than just full auto. But yeah, you just absolutely melt everything with, like, full turbo palm shot. I've already 7 minutes of the unskippable cutscene. Lots of things, by the way. Can't remember if I said hello. Yeah, I've heard speedrunners complain about that game. On that note. Like, it puts people off speedrunning because there's just so many cutscenes in the game you can't skip. Yeah, see, so this is my kind of beef after going back to the game. Because I feel like this is how the game is meant to be done. I don't know. Oh, shit. But yeah, this is how the game would meant to be done. So, when you have a new game file, and you know, it just takes you forever to kill everything, it just doesn't feel quite the same. From Wikipedia article, the GameCube version was sold 1.6 million, the PS2 version sold 2.3. That's not factoring in how long, you'd think though, that would have, that has to factor in development cost for the PS2. They would have had to have ported. Create more, so to say that most of the profits came from the PS2 version, I would say is pretty, it's generous at best, and at worst is just downright misleading. Because I don't know how long it would have taken them to port that, but, you know. Even if it was only, what, a year, let's say? Let's say it took them a year to do that, you know. RE1 Remake sold 1.35 million? God, is that it? Man, that's terrible. Then again, you know, GameCube exclusive, so... I suppose for a GameCube exclusive, it's pretty good. This mission has a good soundtrack. It sold in December of 2005. PS2 port. Did it? Oh, okay, so it wouldn't have taken that long. Really? Was it that fast? Holy shit. That is pretty quick. That's a pretty quick turnaround. But just going by those sales figures, so basically, I'm assuming that his main point in that video is that the remake is the one that actually helped the series, even though that sold less than RE4. I still really wish we'd have gotten RE1 style remakes to it. And as much as I hate myself to admit this, you know if they came out and were like, yeah, we're gonna remake RE2 and 3 again, but we're gonna do them in the style of RE1, I'd think, you fucking bastards, because I'm still gonna buy those. Because that's what I've wanted this whole time. You fuckers. You know what else is really expensive now? Just popping my head. Does anyone remember the chainsaw controller editions of Resident Evil 4? They are pricey now on eBay. They really are expensive. Alright, I'll continue this run and we'll upgrade the Papillon soon as much as we can. If they remake Shadow of Rome, oh, that'd be so cool. You know what though, Shadow of Rome, you don't have to remake Shadow of Rome. Just put that game out on, you know, current shit. Just put it out on, you know, on the PSN store and that as a downloadable or whatever. It'd be so cool. I just think Capcom, it feels like Capcom are very much in, you know, money mode at the moment. You know, unless, you know, they are in the business of making, like, big, big money right now. So they could do that, but why would they bother? Are you saying that because RE1 Remake sold so poorly, they took the series in a different direction? The point he's making is that RE Remake would have sold much better if it was not exclusive to the GameCube, and had sold on the PS2. Yeah, but wasn't Code Veronica one of, like, the least-selling Resident Evil games? So how is he coming to that conclusion? Had that happened, the RE series would not look like it was in a troubled state that it was, and... Yeah, but here's the thing, though. Like, that I mean, is that a quote? Because saying that RE was looking like it was in a troubled state is not true. RE was in a troubled state at the time. It didn't, you know, it wasn't appearing like it was in a troubled state. It was. So, again, like, is that a quote, or is that just paraphrasing? What's up, Nem? Yeah, we are, because I've not seen it, so. Again, I don't really watch Mayo's stuff, so. It's, I've said it before, and I'll say it again in the nicest possible way, but I just find him very guilty of the, you know, this is my opinion, so it's right, mentality of making video essays, and it's like, nope, that's not how it works, I'm sorry. It's just, it's not how that works. While you're at it, can you look up Code Veronica? Because I'm thinking, you know, and also, wasn't Code Veronica a launch title for PS2? Or, like, damn near close to launch? So, again, I'd have to check, because my memory's not that good, but, you know, if that's a point, then, you know, if Code Veronica, you know, run emulator, I don't have to fucking alt-tab here. Oh, I love it. I love it. When did Code Veronica come out? And I love Code Veronica. I hope we get a Code Veronica remake. Here we go. It was released in the Dreamcast in 2000. When was it released on PS2? I can't release the related version. No, I would have thought that would have been in Wikipedia. Like, on the byline. I guess not. Code Veronica X. That came out in the 3rd of February, 2000. No, that's the Dreamcast release date. God damn it, Google. As someone noticed it in chat. Code VX sold 1.5 million copies on PS2, more than RE Remake's 1.35. Yeah, so doesn't that kind of invalidate that point then? If the classic Resident Evil sold more than the remake on the platform where all the Resident Evil fans were, then, again, doesn't that kind of, you know... And also, using sales to make any kind of concrete argument is always a... It's always a bit hit and miss, but if that's his point, then wouldn't that kind of go very much against that? It's just a YouTuber who started believing his own bullshit and started forcing it on everyone else. I mean, I don't watch it enough to really comment on that, but as I said, yeah, like, the bits that I have... His style video is kind of what made me really, like, stop watching his stuff, because the amount of just straight-up wrong information in that video is shocking. And yet, you know, he puts it across as, you know, like, just concrete... The sky is blue, this is how it works, and you think, oh man, you know, even some of the stuff that he mentions about God of War, which is, like, you know, his, the game that he seems to have played the most, like, even the stuff he mentions about that, some of that is wrong, and I think, man, you know, you should have maybe researched this video a little bit more. So, I mean, as far as attempts to change the meaning of the word inconsistent, when referring to headshot stuns in RE4 Remake? I've not seen that video, so I'll take your word for that. In what way, though? Like, what do you mean? Curious. God, this game has a good soundtrack, though, man. This game has such a good soundtrack. No worries, Demon. Thanks for stopping by, man. I will catch you later. He reminds me of people who try to distort studies to fit their own agenda. Yeah, but I don't feel like he's really alone in that. That's YouTube 101 these days. Everyone's a fucking politician, you know? Everyone's a politician. I can send you a clip of what you said about headshots. I mean, I'm not gonna watch it. now, sorry. I'm just curious what you meant by him changing the meaning of the word inconsistent. Because inconsistent is... It is inconsistent. You know? I can't paraphrase it, but he really did a spin on the meaning of the word inconsistent. Essentially, he was defending a garbage design decision that got modded under a week. So that says, oh, okay, fine. Yeah. You know, on that note, and it always, that makes me laugh, because it's like, it's one of the, because I don't really make reactionary videos, like, ever. But the one exception was when I made that video saying that the Halo Infinite trailer was terrible. You know, the reveal trailer they did for Halo Infinite? And for the most, like, you know, and there was people, like, that got, obviously got caught up in the YouTube algorithm because it was new and it was trending. And then there were people being like, the game looks amazing, man. You're just a hater. Nah. And then 343 delayed the game by a year. And I thought, ooh. Ooh. Now, like, if the game looked so good and so amazing and so polished and so ready to release, then why'd they delay it? You fucking clown. It's like 343 don't care about you, man. They're not looking at your YouTube profile being like, this guy defended us on this video, so we're gonna send him money. Like, Jesus, man. I haven't tried the beta, no. To be honest, I'm probably going to miss it because I'm lazy. But I did fire up the demo yesterday. No, not yesterday. The day before yesterday. And I do like it. I like it a lot. That game feels very good to play. So I am excited for that to come out. I am. Yeah, I don't think I'll get time to play that. So, you know. They shaved off some dev time so that they could work on Beautiful Joe. What is that in there? I know YouTube chat. YouTube is behind Twitch, but I don't think it's behind by that. Let Halo Infinite be buried and forgotten. They can't, though. I don't think they can. That's the funny thing about that game. That's the crazy... You know what Halo Infinite is? It's like the Emperor of Mankind in 40K, man. Bear with me. They should let him die. They should let it die, but they can't because he's the savior of Microsoft. There's an analogy for you. You know? It's... They can't because it's Halo. You know, they can't take Halo outside and shoot it. They just can't do that. So, you know, I don't know how Halo Infinite is doing. My guess would be not very well. So. They shaved off. Oh, okay, it's in reference to this game. I see what you made. Yeah, this game was made in 6 months. Yeah, which I think is pretty crazy. Like, with how well this game is in a lot of ways, like, the fact that this was made in 6 months is crazy. Slowly, that's true, yeah, the more I get into 40k, that'll be 40k related. But yeah, they can't let Infinite die, because they also can't, ever come out and admit, you know, 343 just fucked this game so badly. And that was another one, that again, I will point out that I was right, I'm sorry, but just you based. Yeah, when Halo Infinite came out, everyone was all, this is amazing, this is amazing, it's the best Halo ever, and then a month later, everyone's all like, oh, yeah, we're not playing this anymore, and you think, wait a minute, I thought this was better than Halo 3, why have you all stopped playing it after a month? You know. Like, Palpatine keeps coming back, yeah. And, you know, I've said it once, I'll say it again, but... I never wanted that for Halo. I never wanted that. I wanted Halo Infinite to be, you know, the game that got me back playing Halo all the time, but... I just... Nope. Sorry. That did not happen, did it? That's why I didn't buy into... No, me neither. And again, I feel like if you are, you know... Phrasing is gonna, you know, there's no... perfect way to put it, but if you are an enthusiast, let's say, if you follow games passionately and you understand how they are, you understand at least to some extent how they are made, there is no way you watched that Halo Infinite reveal and thought, you know, and genuinely thought, oh, this game looks amazing, this looks really polished and ready and good. there's no fucking way you thought that if you watched that. So that's what I mean when, you know, it wasn't surprising because people are stupid, but when I saw those comments on that video, I thought, man, you guys are just, you're so desperate for a new Halo game that just anything is gonna, like, you think anything is gonna look great. And you think, sorry, but it's just not the case. You fucking whore. Shit, that one was my fault. Hello? Yeah, oh man, look at that. Look at those points. Look at all those points. Hey, Solar starts to make Microsoft look incompetent so they can acquire Activision. Damn, that's a great that's great, actually. Even though that's a troll, that's a great conspiracy theory. They intentionally, like, just told 343, hey, make the game suck, then we can buy Activision. I love that. That's now canon in my mind. That's why Halo is terrible now. They just wanted to buy Activision to get Call of Duty. That's a top tier conspiracy theory, right? I approve. Halo Infinite was terrible, but they did make a decent grappling hook. Yeah, they did, but let's... Again, okay, here... Okay. Show of hands in the chat. How many people think that the only reason that game has a grappling hook is because Doom Eternal had one? Because I do. I don't think that grappling hook was meant to be there, but they're just like, oh, people love Doom Eternal, and people love the grappling hook. Fuck it. Let's put one in there. Why not? Yeah, like, I have nothing to support that other than my own cynicism, but... I feel like that's why that game has a grappling hook in it. And honestly, thank God it does. Can you imagine if it didn't? God, how fucking boring would it be? Wake up, you fuckers. That was close. See, look, like, that just doesn't work on any other suit or mode. Not gonna lie, I was naive once, but I learned my lesson. Yeah, that's the problem with having been, you know, insanely passionate about games for 30 years. And you know, people then say, oh, you're just cynical, you're just jaded. And you think, no, it's just the way things are, unfortunately. It is easier to assume that something's gonna be trash and disappoint you than it is assume everything's gonna be great. If you assume everything's gonna be great, it's probably not gonna be. I don't know why, but I thought I had Papillon on. I just went to do an energy drive, but I don't have. Yeah, what's up, Stringer? That's the problem with it. That's the tragedy of Halo Infinite. Mechanically, it's fantastic. Mechanically, it's great. It just has no soul. It's the most soulless fucking game you've ever played. And the fact that a Halo game is like that is just a fucking... Oh, it just makes you want to cry. You know? It still plays better than the Saints Row reboot. I've not played that. Has anyone played that Saints Row reboot? I don't even know what it's called. But yeah, the latest Saints Row. Apparently it was terrible. And yet the Saints Row 3 remake was fucking awesome. To be fair, is it bad when certain games follow a good trend in gameplay? If the grappling hook is fun in one game, is it bad when it's fun in another? Here's the thing with that. Not necessarily, but you run the risk of making everything play the same way. For example, right? You know what was really cool in Assassin's Creed? Where you climb up to the top of the tower, and you hit a button, and you get that whole, hey, look at the game, and now the map opens up. You know... Oh, shit. My bad, Al. I got carried away there. Yeah, man, is it fucking... It's 5:30. Shit. Okay. Man, I was not paying attention to the time there. Did I save? I did save tonight. What's up, Al? I'm just gonna hop off here, and then I will jump on. Yeah, me and Al were supposed to go on Discord like half an hour ago, and I totally forgot. See? Y'all got me talking about Halo. You got me agitated. No, it's cooler. I had no idea it was that late, honestly. Because I'm getting quite hungry, actually, so. But yeah, just to quickly, like, finish off that point, though. Yeah, so, like, not necessarily. Like, the whole, you know, mimicking another game is not necessarily a bad thing, but remember the towers in Assassin's Creed, right? When, you know, you'd go up to the towers in Assassin's Creed, that was really cool. Until it was in every fucking open world game. Ever. You know? It's even in Horizon. You know, they even kind of riffed on it for Horizon. You go up to the Tall Necks to expand the map and that, and you think, yeah, it's cool, but I feel like that's what you run the risk of with that stuff, is you run the risk of homogenizing a genre to the point where everything just feels like you're playing the same game. So, you know, on the surface, no, it's not necessarily a bad thing, but there is definitely that pitfall to be mindful of. So, yeah. Not necessarily, but, you know, it's the same with, you know, it's like it's the same answer to everything on that front, you know? It's like, well, it depends, you know? Yeah, Horizon does do it a bit differently, but, you know, the same core kind of concept is, you know, climb a big tall thing and the map opens up. So, you know. Breath of the Wild is literally just a tower climb. I never got that far in Breath of the Wild. I found that game extremely boring. So. It's, Is the new one, is the new Zelda, like, the same blueprint for that, by the way? Has anyone played that? Is it Tears of the Kingdom? Is that, you know, open world, like Breath of the Wild? Or is it, you know, how they used to be? So. So you think, alright, Al, I'm gonna go grab a drink, and then I'll hop on Discord. Yeah. I'm so glad you jumped on, otherwise I would have completely forgot. I had no idea it was that late. I thought it was like 3 o'clock, honestly. I really did. In my head, it was about 3 p.m. Sorry. I haven't played either, but it seems the blueprint is the same. I mean, yeah, why would they change it, really? I mean, apparently Zelda, you know, invented open world games, right? That's what I heard. Breath of the Wild was the first open world game ever. So why wouldn't they carry on riffing on that revolutionary genre that they invented? Makes perfect sense, really. So. Anyway, no one's on, so there's no one to raid, unfortunately. But I will catch you guys during the week. Hopefully, I will have the PN3 run in the bag today. And then I will post when the commentary will be. It's probably going to be Friday. I'll probably do the commentary for it Friday night, because it's only going to be around 2 hours, the full run. And then that's it. I am free. I am free of projects. I can just chill and play some games. So, first game is Metal Gear Solid 3. I'm going to play through that on stream. That should be a lot of fun. So, thanks for watching, guys. I will catch you later. Peace.